here on Q57. I'm Dr. Laura Murillo, presidency of the Houston Hispanic Chamber of Commerce, and we're back talking with Commissioner Rodney Ellis. So earlier we were talking about your role currently at the County Commissioner's Court, but you mentioned something that's important. You're a political science major. So we want to know, what were you like in high school? Were you always the politician you are today? Or did you just break out of this shell and become very engaging?
I was always a quiet, unassuming, reserved kid.
Sure, and it just grew on you when you became a politician.
I think it was, I was the normal route for someone who ended up in politics.
Yeah.
On the debate team.
Yes. Where'd you go to high school?
For the folks who don't know. I went to Worthing High School.
Worthing. HISD, product of HISD.
Public schools all the way through.
Yeah, yeah.
And when I came out of high school, my senior year is 1972. That's when, under the Voting Rights Act, we went to Sangamon District. So you had Mickey Leland, Craig Washington.
Yes, all of these phenomenal leaders.
You know, Sissy Farenthal was Bill Hobby. Yes. I worked on his campaign. It was an exciting time.
So
and
what
we
was
jumped
your,
right in it.
So what was your first introduction to politics as an intern, as an employee? What was your first?
When
first
I ran for student council.
In high school.
President in high school.
Did you win?
I won. I was lucky. And it was a great experience.
I was president in my high school class, too. Yeah. And I was shy and reserved just like you.
The debate team, I bet you won that.
Austin High School could not afford a debate team.
Yeah. Well, we had
football or debate.
Now, I must admit, we didn't have those nice metal file boxes, but we did okay.
Yeah. Well, debate, that had to have really been something that really opened doors for you to understand the power of words and getting your message out. And it's played a big part of who you are today.
The number one fear most people have is public speaking.
Yeah.
And, I learned early on how to get beyond it, how to just look over the heads. And I tell young people now, the ability to speak and write is so critical.
It really is. And now with all of these tweets and everything else.
With all those three-word deals, it's a real challenge.
It's very different. So, okay, you go from Worthing, you go to college. Where did you go?
I went to Xavier, New Orleans for 1 year.
Okay.
And then Rod Page gave me a scholarship
Dr.
to come
Rod
back
Page.
To Texas Southern.
Yes.
It was a football scholarship.
Okay.
Although I'm not very athletic.
What did you play? What position?
I didn't play anything. I tutored athletes.
You were left out.
I tutored them, and I raised money for the athletic department. But it was, since the statute of limitations has run, it was a football scholarship. And then when I graduated from Texas Southern, I went to Austin to go to the OBJ school.
Okay.
And I started working around the state capitol for Bill Hobby, whose campaign I'd worked in, 3 years earlier when he ran, when I was a senior, 4 years earlier when I was in high school. And I was around the state capitol from 75 until 1981, came out of law school, worked at the Railroad Commission a minute, then went to Washington, D.C. as Congressman Mickey Leland's chief of staff. You called it an AA back then, administrative assistant.
Okay.
I did that 2 years, and with his support, ran for a seat on the Houston City Council.
Yes.
And I won that seat in 1983, and I've been in politics on my own in elective office since 1984 when I got sworn in.
Tell us about your parents. What did they do?
Hardworking parents. My dad, who's still alive, 96 years old, sixth grade education. He was a yard man by day and a nurse's aide at night, graveyard shift. So to value hard work. My mother was also a nurse's assistant, would work at convalescent homes, and a maid, worked hard. Three kids, two bedroom home, one bathroom, taught me how to manage my time, how to be neat, how to be orderly, and also taught me a lot about what I didn't want to do. Yeah. Taught me about the value of an education. I didn't want to do as much work as my parents did.
Yeah.
And so I didn't want to work two jobs, so now I work about 10 jobs by being in politics.
Well, but they gave you that foundation to help you understand the importance. And I bet you go back to Worthing High School every now and then.
I do. And my father still lives in the house that we grew up in. My sister, who you probably don't remember, Melody Ellis, was president of the school board.
I do remember.
So we were both in public office for a while at the same time. She's a PhD from U of H.
Yes.
She keeps my dad. So the house we grew up in is still in the family. And it must be, half a mile from Worthing High School.
Yeah. So your time in the Senate, one or two things that you're proudest of that you accomplished?
That Texas grants bill. Yeah, at the time, it was the largest state-funded college tuition program to give free tuition to kids who qualified for it in the history of the country. So I'm very proud, and I'm proud to have had the privilege of being the chair of the Finance Committee, picked by a moderate Republican, Bill Ratliff. Yeah. That was 16 Republicans, 15 Democrats in the Senate. Mm-hmm. It was the first time when I was finance chair we passed a bill, the budget, unanimously. So I had to work with colleagues that philosophically didn't see things the way I did, but I think that was a highlight. A lot of stuff in that budget I think we still benefit from.
Yeah. And the last question, you know, I know you've got some very successful children. How many kids, and give folks an update? I know you had a Columbia student.
We have four kids, yeah. And our kids go from 15 years old yeah. to 30 years old.
Yes.
But we didn't put all of that pressure on one wife or one husband.
Okay.
I have one, my wife has one, we have two together.
Divide all of that responsibility.
So one is with the Washington Post, just yeah. did a very successful series about yeah. should she freeze her eggs. Yeah. The second one graduated from Tisch, NYU in New York, and she's working for a startup.
Yes.
I'm hoping she thinks about going back to grad school, get maybe an MBA.
Yeah.
And we have one son, one boy, who's in his second year at the University of Texas in
yes.
Austin. And we have one who is in her second year at Lamar High School.
Well, thank you for all you do. Congratulations
thank
on
you.
A successful family, and to your parents and your father who's still living near Wortham for all he did to make sure you grow up to be our commissioner.
He prepared me to work with you.
Thank
and
you.
We'll do a lot together.
Thank you,
thank
Commissioner.
You.